Do you see that tattoo? It says free speech first. I fought for free speech all my life. I've lived and died with that crucible. 223 is the channel. 223 Comcast. Tonight, great new show. Leland Vittert, News Nation. 7 o'clock tonight, nationwide. You have to hear about the battle I'm having because I made fun. I bullied the thug that just got charged with shooting Ella French in the face.
Well, we'll see soon if it fits.
Okay.
All right, for bullying over a very, shall we say, strong post regarding the shooting suspects charged in the death of Chicago cop Ella French. Here's the post saying he would, and we quote, like to push the button to drop the pellets of the gas chamber. Mancow joins us now. I hate to break it to you, my friend, but there's no more death penalty in Illinois.
I know. I'm dreaming.
Okay.
Welcome, Leland, to town. I love the new show.
Thank you. There's
no free speech on YouTube or Facebook, but there's free speech here on News Nation. Thanks for having me on.
We're glad to have you.
And welcome to Kabuki Theater of Chicago. And you just saw it with Kim Fox, okay? So, you know, a kaleidoscope of beautiful people. Yeah, dead people. And we're all frustrated because we've been put in our houses. No, we're under house arrest. I did nothing wrong, and yet here I sit under house arrest with these people.
House arrest just
under the lockdowns.
Violence.
And it's coming back. The lockdowns
are
coming
back. You think it's coming back?
Okay. Yeah.
Well, Facebook has locked down your account. Have they unlocked it yet?
I don't know.
You don't know yet?
I haven't checked.
You haven't checked? Do you care?
Yes, because I'm doing a podcast and it's business. And, you know, look, I was able to communicate with Trump when he was in office and I begged him to break these guys up to do something about it. Now he's very boisterous about this. But where was he? Why isn't anyone stepping up to these people? And you can say, yeah, well, it's a private company. Sure. But it's a monopoly. And they really are. Look, they're socialists. They're communists. I mean, giggle if you want, but
I'm not giggling. I understand.
I mean, this is what Russia was like. This is what Nazi Germany was like when they start, you know, free speech. I can't make fun of a guy that shot. You saw the beautiful picture. I can't make fun of him.
I guess this would be the question in terms of what their policy is.
Yeah.
That we'll put the post back up. You said that you didn't want to beat him up on the playground. You said you want to push the button for the gas chamber. You said you wanted to kill him. By that measure, so Facebook should allow you to say you want to kill certain people and not others would be your argument, or should you be able to say you want to kill anybody you want?
Well, I mean, that's ridiculous. Of course not.
But you're asking Facebook to make a determination of who you are allowed to say you want to kill. So that would be the question is, where should since you don't like Facebook's current line, which is nobody, where should they draw the line?
I appreciate your argument. It's the same argument.
It's not an argument. It's just a question.
Okay, no, it's a good question. I appreciate Kim Fox out here, the same deal. We're so interested in coddling the bad guys. Did you see them? Did you see the guys? What did they get me for? Do you know? Because I know they wrote me. They said I bullied him. I bullied him. Did you see the guy with the tattoos on his face?
I did.
They're concerned about him more than free speech. I have a problem with that. Yeah, I think we should be able to laugh at gangbangers and make comments at gangbangers, cop killers. That's what he's been charged with. Yeah, I'm okay with that.
So, and I'm just trying to understand what you think should happen. So you think Facebook should say, there's a certain class of people who are so revolting and who are so awful.
Yeah.
We take the controls off, say whatever you want about them. It's fine. And the rest of us are protected.
Let me ask you something. Do you believe in free speech?
I do.
Okay. That's free speech, brother.
Free speech is a totally different concept.
No, it is not.
First Amendment of the Constitution.
Yeah.
Congress shall pass no law abridging. Doesn't say private corporations shall pass no law.
Well, again, that's when we go back. These people have a monopoly. Come on, Facebook and Amazon.
Not because of the government, because they create a good product. People choose to give a monopoly. Everybody tries to start a second social media company, a second Twitter. It doesn't work.
Look, I have free speech carved in my flesh. I won't embarrass myself by taking it off.
It's not that kind of show.
No, I
you got free speech here, but it's not that kind of show.
I know about the First Amendment, and I do think it's a First Amendment issue.
Okay.
And we'll spin our wheels on this, but I think it's, look, they're silencing voices that are not, I would say, communist, but, you know, not liberal, not Democrat. And talk to anybody watching right now, everybody. If you're pro-cop, if you were pro-Trump, if you're not pro-jab, you get censored.
That's true.
It's everything.
That's true.
So you can say that's a private company and they have a right. Of course. And I have a right to sit here. And I thank you, Leland. This is great. And News Nation, this is free speech. You and I talking. not when I answer you if you shut me down. That's not free speech, and that's what they do. So it's all one-sided.
So in other words, your view is that they should be held to the same standard as the Constitution.
I think it should be free. That's what I think.
Okay, and should there be any, I guess I keep coming back
should
to
there be
question.
Any rules? Of course, you know, I mean, they've been doing live shootings on some of these things, and you can't do that, and you can't yell fire in a, or you can't yell, what is it? You can't yell movie in a firehouse or whatever it is. No, I'm kidding. Okay. I'm kidding. But I mean, yes, there's got to be some rules. I understand it. You can't be, but you know, again, you're giving them the benefit of the doubt when they never give us the benefit of the doubt. If you ask any questions about the jab, if you ask any questions about anything, they shut you down, brother. Do you understand to do business in the modern world right now? You know this. You need the YouTubes. You need these things.
Absolutely, especially in the business you're in right now.
Yes,
you do need
that. That's
them.
Right. I'm doing a podcast.
The business you've been talking about getting into, or people have been talking about you getting into, I should say, Illinois' version of Playbook. Is this launching more podcasts, or is this launching a campaign for governor?
Well, right now my focus is on the podcast.
Okay, fair enough.
I have a lot of people that want me to step up. Right now I should be at this prayer vigil for the cop that got shot in the face. My heart breaks. I was with the cops. I was with 100 cops, John Cantanzara, John Foligno, Pat McGrath, a detective, and a bunch of other cops when they found out their co-worker. Maybe that's why I'm a little emotional tonight, because they found out their friend had been shot in the head by some thug. Oh, and then Facebook's upset about this thug's feelings. The city has been taken over by these folks. And I think it's okay that we fight back a little.
Well, you clearly are. We appreciate it. You're welcome back anytime.
I'm loving your show, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks, brother. God bless. God bless.